Hello students, this is Dr Pushpendra K Jain, associate professor, mechanical engineering department, SIRT Bhopal. SIRT Bhopal is an institution under the prestigious SIS group. In this lecture I am going to teach you the part of the subject renewable energy technology. Code is ME604C as per RGBB curriculum, Jan-June 2020. In this lecture I am going to teach you the subject solar collector. This is part of unit number 1. Basically, solar energy can be utilized in two ways. The incident solar radiations can be utilized for direct heating, or it can be utilized for generation of the electricity by using a solar photovoltaic. So solar collector is a type of device which utilizes or absorbs the solar energy and transfer it to the other medium like water, oil or air for heating, cooling or energy generation purpose. So solar collector absorbs the incident solar radiation, that means solar energy, and converts it to the useful heat which is used for heating a collector fluid such as water, oil or air. That means solar collector absorbs the incident solar radiation for heating an intermediate fluid which can be used for heating, cooling or energy generation purpose. If we talk about the classification of solar collectors, then according to the design, the solar collectors can be classified as non-concentrating type and concentrating type. Non-concentrating type collectors are also known as flat plate collector, and again according to their function these can be classified as liquid flat plate collector or flat plate air heating collector. The basic difference between these two is that liquid flat plate collector utilizes water as the heat transfer medium, whereas flat plate air heating collector utilizes air as heat transfer medium. The different types of concentrating type collectors can be classified as point focus type and line focus type, which concentrates or focuses the energy at a point along a line path. Important point focus type collectors are paraboloid disc collector, hemispherical ball mirror collector and central tower receiver. Similarly, cylindrical parabolic concentrator is a type of line focus type collector. So if we discuss about construction and operation of a solar flat plate collector, you can see the figure. Basically it is a box type construction. It is having housing which can be made up of some metal, and at the top of this housing a transparent cover is mounted, which is generally made up of tempered glass or transparent plastic. This is mounted at the top of this flat plate collector in order to reduce the reflection of the incident solar radiation. That means whatever incident solar radiation which passes through the glass into the flat plate collector, it does not pass again to the surroundings. You can see the absorber plate, which is made up of generally material which is a higher thermal conductivity. The important materials are aluminium, steel, copper. Copper being having the highest thermal conductivity, so generally these absorber plates are made up of the copper. These plates have interconnected tubes within it through which heat transfer medium or fluid like oil, water or air can be circulated. Similarly, when this solar flat plate collector is exposed to the sun for a long time, then there are chances of overheating of this whole device, and there are chances of leakage of the transfer temperature to the surroundings. So in order to reduce that, some insulation is also provided. So you can see thermal insulation also there. So according to the fluids being circulated through the tubes, these solar flat plate collectors can be a water or liquid flat plate collector or air flat plate collector also. The flat plate collectors are generally used when temperature below 100 degrees to be obtained. That means the difference in the temperature and the fluid being circulated through the tubes of the solar collector, flat plate collector, is around 100 degree centigrade. Now we talk about two important applications of the solar flat plate collector. One is solar water heater, and as I told you earlier, that solar water heater is utilized for heating the water. Normally in Indian subcontinents, it is used for heating water during winter season. So you can see the figure. There is a storage tank in which cold water is filled, and it is through the tubes it is connected to the solar flat plate collector. The incident solar radiation falling on the solar flat collector heats the water available within it, and its density changes, and it is circulated to the, and the heated water is circulated to the same storage tank where hot water and cold water mixes, and due to the difference in the density, the warm water remains at the top and cold water remains at the bottom in the tank. So hot water from the tank can be taken for any application, and similar amount of cold water is circulated into the tank. Another application of the solar water solar flat plate collector is the solar space heater. The solar space heater can be utilized in two ways, where this classification is according to the difference in heat transfer medium. The heat transfer medium can be utilized as water, or we can utilize air as also heat transfer medium. If air is utilized at heat transfer medium, then the principle just explained can be utilized for space heating. That means air is circulated through this flat plate collector. The air receives heat, it gets heated and can be circulated to the place where space heating is to be done. Another application is through liquid flat plate collector, in which water is circulated. So the water gets heated and it is circulated to the tank. The heated water is again circulated to another heat exchanger, where it exchanges heat with cold air. So air gets heated due to this heat exchange, and the hot air is circulated to the place for to be heated. So these are two specific applications of flat plate collector. So this is all about this lecture. Thank you very much.